Dear friends, welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, we are going to take a first look at the OpenMV camera module, a board that wants to become the Arduino of Machine Vision. Let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects. In this channel, I share everything about the project I built to help you develop similar projects or inspire you to start making things because it is easy, fun and creative. Subscribe to the channel now if you don't want to miss any future video. A very promising new board hit the market last year. It is the OpenMV M7 camera module. The project started as a Kickstarter campaign 3 years ago, which managed to raise $100,000 to bring the idea from paper to reality. The project aims to bring machine vision close to makers and hobbyists. They want to become the Arduino of machine vision. I love this idea. It is going to make machine vision easy and fun to use. Our project will be able to see the world for the first time. Let's see what the board has to offer. The OpenMV camera module features the following: an image sensor with a resolution of 640 by 480 pixels, an ARM Cortex M7 processor which runs at 216 MHz, 512 kilobytes of RAM memory, 2 MB of flash memory, a microSD card slot, a full-speed USB interface to the computer, SPI I2C CAN buses, 10 I/O pins, a 12-bit DAC and a 12-bit ADC, an RGB LED, MicroPython support and low power consumption. Compared to an Arduino Uno or even an ESP32, we can see that this board uses a very powerful processor. The board costs around $50 and you can find a link to it in the description of the video below. Okay, the specs are great, but what can we achieve with this board? The OpenMV Cam can be used for the following things according to its designers: color tracking, face detection, eye tracking, QR code detection and decoding, April tag tracking, line detection, image capture, video recording and much more. The list of possible applications is impressive. With the use of this board, we can move our projects to the next level. The board can be programmed with an IDE developed specifically for this board. The board runs the MicroPython operating system, so we can program the board using Python. How cool is that? But enough with the specs, let's build something with the board. At first, we have to download the OpenMV IDE. The software is free and easy to use. Each time you use it, the software asks for a registration which costs $15. Since I really love the idea and the board, I quickly registered to support the project. First of all, we have to connect the board to the computer using a USB cable. Next, we have to press the connect button, and now we are ready to write our first program. Let's write a simple blink project. We can program the board using Python. When the program is ready, all we have to do is to press the start button and the program will execute. The LED will start blinking. But the program is not saved to the board yet. In order to do so, we have to go to Tools and select the Save Open Script to the OpenMV Cam option. Press Yes on the pop-up message and we are done. Now, if we unplug the board from the computer and provide power from a power bank, we can see that the blink program is running. We have successfully programmed the OpenMV Cam. If your program does not run if you unplug it from the computer, be sure you have selected the correct drive to associate with the board. If you don't select the correct one, the program won't be saved. Now that we know how to program the board, let's look at another, more advanced example. Jerry Lee, a viewer of the channel, suggested that I should take a look at April tags and OpenMV. So let's load an April tag example. I was not aware of April tags. They are similar to QR codes, but they encode far smaller data payloads between 4 and 12 bits, allowing them to be detected more robustly and from longer ranges. Further, they are designed for high localization accuracy. You can compute the precise 3D position of the April tag with respect to the camera. I simply printed an April tag on my printer. Let's see if the OpenMV module can detect it. I have loaded an example that comes with the IDE. As you can see, the OpenMV Cam module can easily detect the April tag. It can also detect its rotation and distance from the camera. Amazing stuff! We can build some interesting projects with this functionality. I think this functionality is very useful to robotics. We can easily make this robot I built some time ago to follow an April tag. Since I am a complete beginner to April tags, I have to learn more about them before using them. So, stay tuned! While searching at the example programs the board offers, I came across machine learning examples. Can a $50 board execute machine learning applications? It seems that it can. I loaded a demo program and a small pre-trained model. The OpenMV camera module can detect cats, dogs, and other objects in real time. Let's load an image of a dog. As you can see, the program can detect the dog with an accuracy of more than 70%. Of course, the accuracy is not great, but the fact that a low-cost board can run machine learning models is a huge step forward. The possibilities are endless. The board needs around 160 milliamps of current when running the machine learning example. The power consumption is very low, way lower than the power consumption of the Raspberry Pi, which can achieve similar results. I am really impressed by this board. Artificial intelligence is coming fast and it's going to be the next big thing in the maker community. In a couple of years, boards like this one will be common and less expensive. Our devices will be able to see the environment using machine vision. Many problems can be solved if our devices can see and understand their environment. Exciting times ahead! I can't wait to build something with this board. I would love to hear your opinion about the OpenMV camera module. Do you like it and are you going to use it in any of your projects? Please post your comments below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects twice a month. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. I'll see you in the next video.